Hello, everybody. In this video, I'm going to talk about Google Search Labs and test out its three functionalities that I recently got access to. The first one is called SGE, or Search Generative Experience. The second one is called Code Tips. And the third one is called Add to Sheets. Now, this is accessible on the Google homepage when you click on this Flask icon right here called Search Labs. But if you don't have access, you might need to add yourself on the waitlist before trying this out. Now, if this is your first time to my channel, I want to welcome you and recommend you to join my AI newsletter. This is where I'm soon going to start sending out some hand-drawn AI workflows that I create for myself. I'm also in the middle of making a website so you can see what some of those workflows look like. All right, let's get started. So there's a few things to mention here before I test out the individual functionalities. The first one here is that this is an experimental feature and there's some deadlines mentioned here. So the SGE is supposed to end on December and so is the code tips, but the add to sheets will end on September 2023. Now it's not clear whether it's the experimental versions of these tools which will be gone on those dates or that the whole tool will completely disappear. But for now, if you're off the waitlist, you can definitely try these out. Now, the first thing you need to do is to enable them using these toggle buttons right here before they start showing up in the results. For example, if I go on Google right now and type best AI art tools, you're going to see some popular AI art tools show up in this snippet section right here. But if I now go ahead and enable this SGE from this toggle right here and click on the agreement, now if I refresh this page, you're going to see that there's some generation going on right in the middle. Now, this is the Search Generative Experience trying to come up with an AI-generated version of my query. And all the results along with the snippet section show up right below it. Now, there's a few interesting things to note here. The first one here on the right, there's a carousel which has a bunch of articles about AI art tools. Now, contrary to what I was thinking, it doesn't exactly provide you the best AI art tools in this carousel. It just provides a bunch of search results which should get you the result of your original intent of finding the best AI art tools. So these are not the actual tools, these are just articles. So what I'm trying to say here is that the Search Generative AI experience is specific to search. So it's going to add some AI on the actual searching, but not necessarily land you on what you're looking for. Here it says AI art tools use machine learning algorithms and deep neural networks to generate art. These can be used to generate illustration, design products, and generate new ideas. Then it says some of the best AI art tools include a brush pen, a digital AI art generator. So it seems to be giving me physical products as opposed to software AI art tools, which is kind of interesting. Now, if I click on one of these products, you see there's a pop-up right here which directs me to a store where I can purchase this product. So it seems to be directing my search intent towards a purchase versus information. Now, if I go on the top right and click on this button right here, you're going to see that this generative AI search result kind of expands. So basically what it's doing is expanding on what it came up in the carousel. So these are some of the results which were showing up in the carousel. And it's sort of telling me that these lines of information were acquired from these sources. There's also a button right here called Ask a Follow-up. You're going to see that I have an option to ask follow-up questions on my original query. So let me try best free AI art tools. Okay, it says here are some of the best free AI art tools: Pisk Art, Canva, Desgo, Starry AI, Lensa AI, Deep AI, Model Scope, and Pixray. Other free AI art tools include Solgen, Dash-E, Midjourney. That is not free. So this is interesting. Midjourney is not free, so it's giving me an incorrect result here. And Night Cafe also is not exactly free. It gives you some free credits. So I'm not sure where it's getting this information from, but there is definitely some incorrect information here. Now, it also gives you some other suggestions which you can use. For example, here is one. Are there any free AI tools like Midjourney? I'm going to go ahead and click that. It says, here are some free AI tools like Midjourney, Diffusion Art, Playground AI, Stable Diffusion, Crayon, Microsoft Designer, Diffusion B, Stable Diffusion Web UI, DALL-E Flow. And actually, I think this one is more correct. And also, if I expand this right here, it links all the articles that it found that information from. And when you're done with your follow-up questions, you can just click reset. And now there's an option to ask other questions in this window. Now, I have used this I'm feeling lucky button on the Google search. I'm curious about what it does when I try it on the generative AI experience. So I just want to click I'm feeling lucky. What it does is come up with a random query like, how can I increase my reading speed and comprehension, and get me some generative AI results for that query. And by the way, if you have this generative search experience on, it's always going to come up with this section right here. And if you don't need it, what you can do is to just turn this toggle off. And now when you do the same search again, it's going to be gone. All right, the next tool is called Code Tips, where you can get coding tips directly in search. How about let's start with trying an example. So I'm going to click try an example. It says JavaScript check if key exists. Now this is an example of a code snippet to check if a key exists in an object in JavaScript. Let me try the same thing, but with Python, and say Python check if key exists. And it tells me to check if a key exists in a dictionary in Python, you can use the in operator. Let me try asking it about a regular expression and see if it builds one for me. To check all capital letters in a string. Okay, it actually gave me the regex. It says import the regular expression library and then do a re.match. And you go through all the characters from A to Z, starting at the front. And it's also telling me what's happening in the code. The re module in Python provides regular expression support. The caret and the dollar anchors match the beginning and the end of the string respectively. And the A to Z plus character matches any sequence of one or more capital letters. For example, if the following code checks if the string hello is all capital letters, the result will be true. This actually gave me a proper result. Let me make this a bit more complicated. All right, now I have requested a regular expression in Python to check all capital letters, all instances of the character ampersand, all instances of the number 6, and all consecutive occurrences of the letter X in a string. All right, I think I seem to have broken it. It says no AI response to that search. Let me remove the complexity a little bit and keep it a regular expression in Python to check all capital letters and all instances of the character ampersand in a string. Okay, it did actually change the regular expression, and this time take into consideration all the capital letters and also this ampersand that I mentioned. And if someone provides this string, hello ampersand world, this will go and match this regular expression and return me true. So it seems that there might be a few glitches in this code snippet helper, so I definitely recommend you to try running this multiple times. I won't say it's completely useless, because when you're writing code and you want to generate a regex, sometimes it can take a lot of time just to come up with something simple. Where instead of hunting down Stack Overflow, you can just use the code help tool from Google and get your answer. And I'm not sure if it's actually just stealing the answer from Stack Overflow, and I still have to try this out enough times to confirm that. Now, just to end the testing of the code tip tool, let's say SQL inner joins and see what it gives me. Okay, now it seems to have stopped giving me any result. I'm not sure if it's because it's broken or my internet is not working. Let me try refreshing the page. Okay, it does not seem to work for this query. So I feel like you have to ask your questions pretty specific for it to give you a result. And I think you can probably use something like Bing Chat or ChatGPT to get a better result for this. But again, this is experimental and it's very, very early stages. So I don't expect it to work 100% of the time. All right, now I'm going to try the Add to Sheets functionality and enable it right there. And now if I go back to Google and search free alternatives to ChatGPT. All right, it's giving me a bunch of results. The first 4 are sponsored. Let me avoid that and go to these articles. This one is from Elegant Themes. And as soon as I hover over the article, you're going to see this new menu pop up right here. And this is what is enabled from the Add to Sheets functionality. And if I click this button right here, I have this new pop up which shows up. And it's giving me an option to add this search result to this existing spreadsheet. I have this spreadsheet open right here. So when I go ahead and click done, you're going to see that that search result just got added. Now, if I click on that search result, I can go to that article which I found from my original query. Sometimes when you load URLs like these, you either have to deal with ads or pop-ups, and you don't want to deal with that during the original research like I'm doing right now. Let me go to some other articles. This one says 11 ChatGPT alternatives that you can try in 2023. I can go ahead and click that sheet button again, and it's going to add that to my existing sheet. And if I go back to my sheet, you see that second result gets added as well. By the way, you can also click on this sheet and create a new spreadsheet if you want. And I'm going to name this Testing AI New and click Create. And now this search result gets added to this new sheets called Testing AI New right here. So I think this is a pretty neat functionality that I personally would definitely use when I'm doing some research online. Now, if you don't want to add your results to a Google Sheet or you're not a fan of spreadsheets, you can use this other functionality, which is kind of a bookmarking tool, and click this button right here. And it says saved to collection in favorite pages. And if you go to this link called google.com-save while logged into your Google account, you're going to see that both the links that I just saved are showing up in my saved items. Now, let me go ahead and save a couple more. If you want to be a bit more organized and not have all of them in your folder called favorite pages, you can create a new collection and create from all saved items. Let me go ahead and select the ones with say top 10 and create a new one. And now I can name this top 10. Perfect. Now, if I go to my google.com-save, I have two collections, both of which are private, one of which says top 10 and one of which has all my saved items. Now, if I want to make this public and share this collection, all I do is click the share button and set this to sharing. And now I have two options, one which is view only and one where you can contribute as well. All right, that's all the information I have for you off Google Search Labs. If you want all the functionalities enabled at the same time, you can make all of them true and have them all work together. I personally don't like doing that because it's a bit disruptive to how I search and save things. And also, you see, this takes quite a bit of time. So it takes around 5-something seconds. For me, there's both pluses and minuses to using the search generative experience. But like I mentioned in my Google Bard video, AI and Google is still very early. So I'm hoping that this whole experience improves quite a bit in the upcoming months and have this available for everybody to use. So I hope you got some value from today's video. If you did enjoy it, make sure to subscribe to my AI newsletter and YouTube channel and click like on this video. I have a lot more videos coming up. Till the next one, thank you so much.